Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Mary Mount Carmel Blessed Sacrament Church for the Feast of Christ the King. We welcome those of you who have joined us for the very first time since we reopened, and we are pleased that you trust us to keep you safe in our church. I would like to remind you of a few directives to keep everyone safe. I know you've heard these week after week. However, because of the recent number of COVID cases in our county going up, it is especially important for you to follow our protocols. So please remember that your masks must be worn at all times, and they must completely cover your nose and your mouth. I have received numerous phone calls from people telling me so-and-so is sitting in church and your nose isn't covered, please say something. So I'm here to beg you to please keep your nose and your mouth covered. I don't want to have our ushers become mask police, but it's important that you make sure that you do that for your safety as well for everyone else's safety. Also remember that when you leave today, there are baskets at the exits for your donations. We will sit for the Eucharistic prayer. Father Sexton and the ministers will come to you to give you communion. When he comes to you, you stand to be ready for communion. You receive in your hands, move your mouth, your mask, cover your mouth, consume it, and then cover yourself back up. And please wait at the end for our ushers to let you know when it is time to leave. They will let you know which exit to leave by and when it's time to go. So please be patient for all of that. And if you take a moment now to please silence your cell phones.
Jesus. celebrate Christ the King on this last official weekend of the Catholic Church worship year. Next weekend is Advent, a new Catholic year of worship. So we honor our Lord and call him as King of all creation. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of God and the love of our Lord Jesus, may the fellowship of the Holy Spirit now be with all of you.
Amen.
As we are gathered into God's house this November weekend, once again we seek the gift of peace and pardon that come from the Lord. Lord, you were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy. O Christ, you invite even the sinner to walk by your side. Christ, have mercy. And Lord, you do plead for us now at the right hand of God the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Jesus, in his care for us, may Christ the King, our not faults, forgive our sins, and even bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And we make our prayer, Almighty God, whose will is to restore all things in Christ, who is King of all creation. We pray that all of creation, set free from the slavery of sin, may render to you worship that is worthy, and ceaselessly proclaim the greatness of your name. For you are Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's be seated, everybody, to listen to God's word.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after and tend my sheep. As a shepherd tends his flock, when he finds himself among his scattered sheep, so will I tend my sheep. I will rescue them from every place where they were scattered when it was cloudy and dark. I myself will pasture my sheep. I myself will give them rest, says the Lord God. The lost I will seek out, the strayed I will bring back, the injured I will bind up, the sick I will heal. But the sleek and the strong I will destroy, shepherding them rightly. As for you, my sheep, says the Lord God, I will judge between one sheep and another, between rams and goats. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all died, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ the first fruits, then in his coming, those who belong to Christ, then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. When everything is subjected to him, then the Son himself will also be subjected to the one who subjected everything to him, so that God may be all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Well, we're getting ready for Thanksgiving Thursday. We have a Mass on Thursday morning, as we always do, 9 o'clock. And we'll be safe and sound and cautious, so it's great to have people start that day with a brief, simple, but very nice Holy Mass on Thanksgiving morning at 9 o'clock. It's kind of an odd year, just like with everything else in 2020, even Thanksgiving. Somebody told me the other day, they said, the only thing harder than having a house full of relatives and friends for Thanksgiving, the only thing harder is not having a house full of friends or relatives. Might be a little different, huh? I heard another story. This man, he was married, he was a dad, he called his son who lives in Chicago, the man lives in New York, he called his son and said, listen, he said, it's 2 days before Thanksgiving, your mother and I are getting a divorce. And the son, in shock on the phone, said, Dad, wait, no, where did this come from? He said, I'm going to jump a flight, I'll be there in a day or two. And then the man called his daughter in Los Angeles and said, 2 days before Thanksgiving, he said, your mother and I are getting a divorce. And the daughter was in shock. She said, no, Dad, don't jump to anything. Wait, I'm going to jump a flight. I'll be there in a day or two. And then the man, the dad, the married man, turned to his wife, gave a big hug and a kiss. He said, honey, it worked. Not only are the kids coming home, but this time they're paying for their own flight. This feast of Christ the King, it wraps up, it's like an exclamation point at the end of the official Catholic Church year of worship. Next weekend, Advent, we step into a new Catholic Church year of worship. And this feast of Christ the King originated way back when, 1925. The Catholic Church and the Pope at that time, Pope Leo XI, they saw this rising threat of dictators around the world, Italy, Spain, Germany, Russia. And these guys were telling people that they were the ultimate authority over people's lives. You know the names. They all are in a heap of ashes now, but they caused a lot of trouble in the world. And so the Catholic Church said, no. The Church said, Jesus, the good Lord, has the ultimate authority in the lives of his faithful people, really over the world. So the Church at that time said, we're going to celebrate Christ as King, King of all creation, King of everyone's heart. And so that's how we got the feast this weekend of Christ the King. And really, the question for you and I, and I'm glad it happens at least once a year, the question for you and I, before we leave the doors that we came in, the question is, well, who has the ultimate authority? Who does rule my life, my thoughts, my attitudes, my behavior, my habits, my style, my decisions, my choices? Who really does have the ultimate authority in my life? It's a good question. Is Jesus right up there, you know, along with wife and husband, you know, other people, but is our Lord really that significant in the way we choose, decide, act, how we are? It's a good question at the end of our Catholic Church year. And sometimes you can tell the people who have said, you know what, Christ is very big in my life. He has a lot to say in what I do and how I am. People like that, I don't know, sometimes you can spot them. They're good, faithful, good people. They don't like to judge others too quickly or harshly. They tend to give people a break. They're the type of person that, they don't worry too much. They don't lose too much sleep. They'll say, Lord, you carry this burden on your shoulders and we'll deal with it tomorrow. They're the type of people who like to be connected to other people. They're not like people who like to be separate from everybody. There's people like that, not just during the pandemic either. And they're the type of person that, they have a sense of humor. They know that certain things you can kind of laugh them off. They don't have to ruin your whole day or your life. People who say, Christ is the big
ruler. He is the big influence in how I am. Sometimes you can spot people who have made that choice, Jesus as King. Now why does the church give us this gospel? It's a famous one, you know. I was hungry, I was thirsty, I was naked, I was in prison. Well, because you and I are invited to share in the work of the King, King Jesus, the Good Shepherd. We're invited to share in his work, which is the gospel this weekend. That's how our Lord wants to be honored. Somebody else that's a king or a royalty, I don't know, they want people to always bow before them or something. But Jesus wants to be honored as King in our lives by our sharing in the work of Christ the King, to feed the hungry, give to the thirsty, visit the sick. And it doesn't always mean to take it literally. To visit somebody in prison might be to have a word with somebody who's in some addiction, or they put themselves in a kind of prison that's hurting their life. They need somebody to pull them in and let them live a better life. Maybe it's not just literally feed the hungry, but it might be to feed someone who has a hunger for the reason for their living. Maybe a young person, they hunger, they thirst for, why am I here? What's it all about? What should I be doing? Maybe they need a little word, a little direction, a little encouragement. So that gospel is great for the feast of Christ the King. And the question is before us, how big of an influence do you let Jesus have in your life? Somebody, we're going to have Thanksgiving Thursday, a great American holy day, holiday. And these words I gave to you before, they're from an old American spiritual song that they would sing down south. I love these words. Jesus, you are the rule of life for me. The way of love you taught is the way I want to walk. Lord, rule my heart, my mind, my soul. Be the sovereign of the way I go. Beautiful words, very simple. That's it in a nutshell, why we celebrate Christ the King. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May we together stand and profess our creed, the Apostles' Creed, on this weekend. I believe in God, the Father, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Christ the Father, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father of all men. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. May we, with trust in our Lord's care for us, may we again place our petitions, our prayers before the same Lord.
Please respond in order to hear your people's prayer. For Pope Francis and all who lead within the Church, may they be strong in shepherding the world with compassion and with love, that we all may know the joy of welcoming the lost, healing the injured, and caring for the abused. We ask,
Lord, hear the people's prayer.
For the grace to live in the Spirit of Jesus, may we regard all others with dignity and with respect. May we be willing to give without expectation to all who are in need and to those who depend upon us. We ask,
Lord, hear the people's prayer.
May every world leader comprehend the depth of human suffering that prevails in our world at this time. May they work together to find more effective ways to deal with this pandemic, to curb the destructive forces of selfishness, and to bring peace where there is violence and division. We ask,
Lord, hear the people's prayer.
facing difficulty, depression, or unemployment, for those confronting addiction, grief, or insecurity, for those who are alone, afraid, helpless, or dependent. May all people find the support, courage, and hope they need. We ask.
Lord, hear Jesus' prayer.
We pray for our country during the season of Thanksgiving. May we find reasons to be grateful and ease our tensions in order to remember our many blessings. May this time of suffering help us to grow in gratitude and prayer. We ask.
Lord, hear Jesus' prayer.
For the prayers we offer in silence, we remember especially our beloved sick and dying. We ask.
Lord, hear Jesus' prayer.
Lord, you will be the judge of our lives one day. We will stand before you. And as you do separate those who are rewarded and those who are not, we pray that you count us worthy of the great gift of your pardon, your peace, and your grace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let's be seated. And offering himself on the altar of the cross as a sacrifice
and bring peace, he might accomplish our redemption and make all created things subject to his rule. He might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, of holiness, of grace, a kingdom of justice and of peace. So together with all the voices of heaven, even with the sound of many saints and angels, we raise our hearts in a song of praise.
Remembrances.
Have mercy on us, we pray, that with Blessed Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, and with Saint Joseph and all the holy apostles and saints, those who pleased you, we too will be worthy to become the heirs to eternal life. May we come to praise you and even give you glory through your Son, Jesus. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
It will be held on Saturday, December 12th, from 2 to 4 p.m. Cars can line up in the parking lot by entering J Street, stopping at the gym door, take a quick photo with Santa outside the car, and receive a present and a drink bag. You must fill out a reservation form so that no child is without a gift. Forms are available on the table in the bag after Mass on the parish website and Facebook page. An extra ounce will be welcome too. And you can contact Jackie Thibault at 315-732-3232. Thank you.
Thank you, Connie. If you are one of our beautiful lectors, you read God's Word at Mass, the workbooks for our lectors are to be picked up and back here in the sacristy. Also, as I mentioned, Thursday morning, Thanksgiving, we have our traditional 9 o'clock Mass in the morning. Not even an hour long, very enjoyable, and we're safe and sound, very cautious, so I would encourage folks, it's a great way to start Thanksgiving Day. On Friday, after Thanksgiving, there's 8:30 Mass in the morning, as we normally have. There will be 8:30 Mass on Friday morning after Thanksgiving Day. And I do hope you have a nice day. It's going to be a little hot this year, but whatever you do or don't do, I hope you enjoy Thursday Thanksgiving. Now, you know, these kids are very smart nowadays. I wonder now, what did the turkey say when the turkey found out there was a man hunting turkeys out in the field? There was a man hunting for turkeys. What did the turkey say? Quack, quack. See, the kids have got to get back to school. Let's stand for our prayer for the peace of Christ and King, everyone. Lord, having received this sacrament of our faith, we ask that, glorifying in it, we will obey the commands of Christ, who is the King and the Sovereign of our lives, that we may live with him eternally in that kingdom that he has promised through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you now.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you in every way, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Thank you, Lord. Peace.
Thanks be to God.